Ammonia. Which atom is the central atom? Yeah, again, it's the first one. But also, something in the rules to help is hydrogen is not the central atom. Put the nitrogen down, then put the three hydrogens. Now we do the valence count. Look at the columns. Nitrogen is in column 5A. Hydrogen is in column 1A. There's 8 total valence electrons. Divide by 2. There's 4 pair. What do you do next? Bond the surrounding to the central. Then the next rule says follow the octet rule for the surrounding atoms. All right, what's wrong with this? Other than in the rule it says hydrogen only has one bond. Because there's only one bond there. It's too many pair of electrons, isn't it? 3, 4, that's 6 pair. There's another structural issue here. Think back to when we talked about the octet rule. That came from a full valence shell. What's the noble gas in 1A? It's helium, right? The valence shell for shell 1 is only S. There is no P subshell in shell 1. So a full valence shell for hydrogen is 1s2, which means, aside from the too many electron point of view, once you bond up hydrogen, it's sharing a pair with the central atom, it's done. It has a full valence shell. Well, what's the next rule? We've distributed 3 pair, we have 1 more pair. Place any remaining pair on the central atom. So we put it on nitrogen. You can't put it on as a double bond with hydrogen because hydrogen only makes one bond, period. Then we check. Central atom has fewer than 4 pair. Well, it's got a lone pair, it's sharing 3 pair, that's 4 pair. This one is finished.